leader of our party in Lok Sabha. She will start the this press conference.
Namaskar. You know, the question is, are we moving towards autocracy from our great democracy? Because whatever the provisions of our democratic fabric, the constitutional fabric, they are being trampled upon. And it is a matter of great regret that we've been slowly losing our democracy in the form of disregard to the opposition, disregard to the demands of the people of the country, disregard to the constitutional provisions. You see, first, the bills are being passed without being discussed. They are being passed in dins. And very minimum time is being given for discussion or dissent. Within 8 days in Rajya Sabha and 6 days in Lok Sabha, 25 bills have been passed with 10 minutes or less time.
21 together.
And 21
minutes together.
Minutes we have done this, and there is absolutely disregard to the people, you know, the honorable members, when we are asking for time for. There is an instance when an honorable member in Lok Sabha stood up in the seat, maintaining on protocol, and asked for division. Asking for division is a democratic right. It was not granted, the house was adjourned just day before yesterday. So this kind of autocratic behavior we've never seen in the nation. Not only this, this government is slowly moving towards ordinances. And we have seen that, you know, in the first 30 years, there were only one ordinance, 2 10 bills after independence. In the next 30 years, there were 2 ordinances for 10 bills. But from the 16th Lok Sabha onwards, the average has been 3.5 ordinances or more. This time there has been 3.7 ordinances, and it appears that the House, when in session, has the main function of giving veto on those ordinances, just pass them as bills. Then why call the session at all? Why have the parliament in session at all? Why have the democratic norm at all? So much so that whenever the honorable members stand up, they are not allowed to speak. This kind of undemocratic behavior we have never seen. In India, we work on the lines of the Westminster Abbey, because there the opposition has 20% of the 100 days that they work, 110 days that they work. Here in the Business Advisory Committee, it is like the Kirana store where, you know, the opposition says we will have 4 hours of discussion. Government side, the Treasury bench, says no, it is 2 hours. So you go on haggling for time, haggling for picking up issues and discussing issues which are people-centric. We had completely agreed with the government in the all-party meeting when we said that we would cooperate completely, go in for discussions. There are important issues to be discussed, including the farmers' bills, which are anti-farmer. We wanted to discuss the price rise. We wanted to discuss the serious issue of the COVID-19, which was totally mismanaged by this government. We've lost official number of people, 4 lakhs. Unofficially, though there is a report by Dr. Arvind Subramaniam, that we've lost nearly 35 lakhs of people to this disease. And there is no discussion, though Rajya Sabha managed to discuss it There was no discussion, even calling attention was put by members, even I had put, but it was not admitted. And the most important is the Pegasus issue. Who vetted it? Did the government do it? When the Israeli government is allowing, when the French government is allowing, when the international community are worried about who started this, whether it is started by the government or not. If it is not started by the government, then who did it? Who's spying on us? Who's spying on the people of the country? And it is so unhealthy, it is so dangerous, because it's a military spyware. So who's unleashing this military spyware, the cyber war, on the people of India? Hasn't the country got the right to know? Isn't the elected members of Lok Sabha and the nominated honorable members of Rajya Sabha, they have the right to ask and be answered on the floor of the house to be recorded for posterity? The country should know, the people should know, the world is asking the question. So at the moment, you know, wherever we stand, the country is passing through great danger, and we feel that we are slowly losing on our constitutional democratic fabric, and we are here to discuss the issues. We want to completely comply with the norms and come to conclusion regarding various bills which are people-centric, which have interest of the people in mind. But this government is not allowing it. They're bulldozing it. This kind of bulldozing behavior cannot be accepted. You know, the Lok Sabha does not have a speaker even after 782 days. This is the highest number of days that we've had since we had a deputy speaker. The highest number previous to this was 270 days in the 12th Lok Sabha. But now it has crossed 782 days. There is no deputy speaker in the Lok Sabha. Not a single question has been answered in the Rajya Sabha by the PMO. And when the houses, when the honorable members have demanded the presence of honorable Prime Minister and the honorable Home Minister to lay down their answers or come and answer and have some discussions, the members' requests have not been heeded. So we would like to point out that the country is passing through great danger. This government appears to be dangerous for the people of the nation.